मंगलम भगवान विष्णु मंगलम गरुड़ध्वज मंगलम पुंडरीकाक्षो मंगलायतनो हरिः सर्वमंगलमांगल्ये शिवे सर्वार्थ साधिके शरण्ये त्र्यंबके गौरी नारायणी नमो स्तुते नारायणी नमो स्तुते
dear divine souls, respected Gurumukh, respected dear Sadhvi Bhagavati ji, a beautiful devotional heart, our dearest Sanatan Kaur, all the beautiful musicians, all the members and extras of Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan, my dear Sudhir Bhai, Asu Bhai, and Acha. Matri Shakti, my sisters and brothers. As Sadhvi ji explained beautifully, the heart of compassion. Sometimes I think, when I was very little, I was in the jungle, I saw the rishis, the seers, the sages being there in the mountains and writing beautiful prayers. And prayers, if I translate in English, say, may all be happy, means sarve bhavantu sukhina. Sitting there in the mountains, they left their families left the whole world, living in the jungle midst of nowhere, and there also they are not praying to the divine, O Lord, make me happy. O Lord, make me healthy. There also, they are just praying, Sarve bhavantu sukhinah, Sarve santu niramayah, Sarve bhadrani pashyantu, Ma kashchit dukkha bhag bhavet. You are gone to the Himalayas, left everybody, and talking about, may none be suffering, may no one be suffering. Sitting there, this is a heart of compassion, expansion for all. There are two things. One is passion, other is compassion. The whole spiritual journey, spiritual life is a shift from passion to compassion. Passion is, I love ice cream, I love chocolate, I love diamonds, and you go on and on. List is very long. Never ending list. Passion means, what for me? Thinking about myself. When you think about yourself, it means you are under the influence of passion. Me. Me is in the center. That vertical me want to see me higher and higher and higher, no end. And there is the other way of living, the life of compassion, that having a shift from passion to compassion. Sometimes we shift ourselves from one house to other house, from one city to other city, from one place to other place, one friend to other friend. one car to other car, maybe this model, maybe a new model, maybe that model. We keep shifting our focus. And passion is amazing, passion for anything. And I have seen in the scriptures that one king was so passionate about life and living after 100 years, he had four sons. And he asked his son, can you give me 25 years? I want to live more. Imagine a man, a king who has lived life fully, 100 years, and his children are still coming up, learning to live life, and he's asking, if you give me 25 years, the older one said, Dad, are you crazy? Asking for my 25 years? He asked another one. Three of them refused. Then the fourth one, the youngest one, he said, yes, I want to give not only 25 years, I want to give my whole life to you. He called him. He said, no one else, none of your other brothers said, we want to give our life. How you came up and said, I want to give. He said, Dad, I thought there must be something that you have lived your hundreds of years. Even those hundred of years, you are not happy. You are still looking for more and more and more. It means having more is not the answer. Having more is not, nothing wrong in having more, but having more is not the answer. There is something else which can take me beyond of this having more. I want to look for that. Take my 25 years, but rest of my years, I want to go on that journey which can take me from having more to be more. Dad listened to his younger son's answer, and immediately he also got the message. He's right. Life is not to have more, life is to be more. Passion always tells you more, more, and more. But spiritual life, the spirituality does not mean, when I say spiritual life, that you go to the jungle, go to the mountains, leave New York. My God, what a life! From every window you see cars and cars and cars, millions of people going from one side to the other. It's great. But you are a real yogi living here. It's easy to be in the mountains and maintain calm, maintain coolness. It's easy to be in the jungle and become yogi. But if you give a little shift, little bit shift to yourself, you can be really wonderful yogis. Being here in, right in New York, it can happen. Having your business on, having your job on, everything is on, but still you can become yogi. The yoga is not, I always say, when you go all the way to the mountains and what you do yoga. Yoga is what you are. Wherever you are, whatever you are doing, in all of that, just see, is yoga happening? Watch, is yoga happening? Yoga gives you that shift. Even after having all that passion, and passion is not wrong. Don't take me wrong. If there was no passion, people have not gone to the moons. They had a passion to go there. Passion is great, but passion for what? When passion is for yourself, then becomes a problem. Only for yourself. And when that same passion is converted to compassion, then it becomes for others. Dalai Lama ji, she started with His Holiness the Dalai Lama, because we are several times we meet each other, and he is in a cute way, says so many things. He is very cute. Very cute. Once he said, if you want others to be happy, have compassion. And if you want to be happy, have compassion. There's no other way. If you want others to be happy, have compassion. And if you want to be happy, have compassion. Compassion is a shift in our heart. A heart of compassion means a heart of love. A heart of compassion means heart of generosity. Heart of forgiveness. It needs a lot to forgive somebody. Here you need a compassion. Forgiving someone is not easy. Forgiving someone and then forgetting that forgiveness is not easy. You need a heart of compassion. And that comes through your spiritual practice every day. Expanding your heart. Breaking those barriers and boundaries every day. When you are talking about Uttarakhand, what the tragedy happened in Uttarakhand, which brought us together here to offer our prayers, homage for them. What is that? Where is Uttarakhand? Where is New York? They are there, we are here. What is that which connects us together? It's compassion. It seems like they are there and we are here. But when we have a heart of compassion, then there are no boundaries. It's not they are there and we are here. We are all one. We are one in their pain, in their sufferings. And if we share that suffering, that pain, believe me, being here also, we can have that practice of compassion and we can help them all. We can embrace them all. That spirit which brings me together. Spirituality means that connecting to the spirits makes us one. That oneness, that openness comes through practice of sadhana, spirituality, meditation. There's a beautiful mantra in Sanskrit. I am means me. This one, Nijaha. I am Nijaha. Paro Veti means whoever is front of me, this one is mine, and the other person who is there is different, is other, not mine. Said people who think in that way, they are big, their heart is very laghu, means very small, very small. But people who have an expanded heart, people who have a heart of compassion, for them, udar charita namtu vasudhaiva kutumbakam, the whole world is one family. Not only my two are mine, but the whole world becomes one family. So on the path of spirituality, we have to practice every day. And then when you practice every day, then your whole focus changes. Takes a new shift. It's not you will look different. You will be the same from outside, but your heart will become very different. Then whenever you earn or when you are spent, you will be very conscious. You live simply. Mahatma Gandhi used to say beautiful thing. Live simply so that others may simply live. Then I am a conscious buyer, conscious wearer, Whenever I buy something, I think 200 times. Do I need this? Sometimes we are in the shopping center and shopping is amazing. It makes people crazy. This shelf and there, they are very smart. Even when you are leaving to the door, you are at the till, this giving the money, they have so many catchy things. Even you don't need it. But then you also forget which shelf is my pink color shoes is there. Amazing. If you go and open the cupboard, it's like rainbow colors. It's no problem. Collecting those rainbow color things, not a problem. But our life should stay rainbow. And we should start creating through our rainbow in the life of others that same rainbow. Remember, as I said earlier, having more is not wrong, don't take me wrong. But when life takes a shift from compassion to compassion, it does not mean now no excitement, no joy, or no juice in life. It does not mean that when you have the shift from passion to compassion, that now life will be dull. Life will not be interesting, exciting. It's not that. In fact, the meaning is very deeper. That now I don't think about myself only. I think about all. I think about the creation. When it comes to the creation, not only the people, but the animal world, the ocean world, the rivers, the trees. Then I become very, very conscious what I am wearing, what kind of makeup I am wearing, what kind of clothes I am wearing. All of that is somewhere it affects to the whole world. And then you start living and learning, living with less. And living with less does not mean that I have to live poorly, or I have to live as poor. It's not that. Living with less means low maintenance. Low maintenance, yes. Low maintenance means whatever you need, how much you need, have it, and rest you save it, and then share it. And there are people, they live in with those two suitcases, they have one suitcase. But I'm not telling you, have one suitcase only. You will be always ready. Something happened at home, I am going. Take one suitcase. I'm not telling you. Living with less means my needs are now minimum. And our needs are minimum means my desires are less. If our desires are less, our expectations are less. If our expectations are less, peace is more. It is our expectation steals our peace. Because of those expectations, we become slave of others. Because of our expectations, our endless desires, we become slaves of our desires. Let us have this sadhana that every day I have a heart of compassion means now expanding the heart every day for others, for the divine nature. I will not buy those things which are going to create harm to the nature. You all must be vegetarian anyway. It's a wrong place to say be vegetarian. We are in New Year. Sometime out of taste or out of maybe impulsion, maybe under the influence of passion, you know, taste is taste. But let me tell you, when I'm talking about the creation, in that creation, you all who are sitting here today, even all of you can make a pledge. I am going to try to live with less and to become vegetarian will save whole humanity. Whole humanity. Your just being vegetarian is going to create a different. People say vegetarian, then what about the proteins? Look at elephant. Never gone to Whole Foods store. Because whenever we come from our ashram to the city, every day we meet elephants. And we have seen them. Even those animals are in front of them. Never ever they attack them. And we ourselves, when we become under the influence of passion, our taste, or whatever you say, you know what we have become. So my prarthana today is, when we are here today, why this happened to the Himalayan valleys in Kedarnath, somewhere someone had the greed. Because of that greed, trees were cut. Because of that greed, so much devastation took place. Because of that greed, because of those desires, today we can see the disaster there. We all together, bring this consciousness. Bring this consciousness. Send a message. Our conscious saving, our conscious wearing, our conscious buying can change the world. And that you all can do. People sometimes who have not gone to the lecture, not done yoga, not done spiritual classes, for them we can understand maybe that thought never occurred to them. But you all are yogis. For you all, even sitting here, 150 or 200 people, if you can change, many things can change, and it can bring a great difference in our world.